Mike Butcher here at TechCrunch Disrupt San Francisco. It's 2014. The world goes to Disrupt, and Disrupt comes to the world, as it were. So here we have the Arabia Pavilion. And the Middle East is really hot right now with startups. And we've got you guys, BAS. Tell us what's BAS.
Yeah, BAS. We automate a job of 3 person in treasury departments. For cash management, for example, we automatically go to the SWIFT network and we collect all the bank statements for treasurers, and we provide them between midnight and 5 a.m. in the morning, all their cash analysis fully automated and reported automatically.
And where are you guys based?
In Paris.
In Paris, but you're serving the whole of the Middle East.
Yeah, and we have a company in Beirut and in Dubai.
There's a big connection between the French and the Middle East, isn't there?
Exactly.
Just like the Brits. Okay, now over here we've got Anghami. So tell us about this, Music Unlimited.
Hello, my name is Eddie Maroon. Anghami is the music streaming service of the Middle East. We have 6 million users. It's an on-demand music service. We have Arabic international music. We're the number one music streaming service in the Middle East, and with a lot of partnerships with telcos, media groups, etc.
Are you trying to be like the Spotify for the Middle East?
Kind of, yeah. We're very much inspired by the Spotify model, but we're very much customized and, you know, we cater for this particular area of the world.
Yeah, and there's a lot of Arab music labels, isn't there?
Absolutely. We have a lot of exclusive content. We have the biggest Arabic catalog plus the international labels on board.
Fantastic. Lovely to see you. Okay. And over here, we've got an actual VC. So we've got... now it's Walid, yeah, from Middle East Venture Partners. Now, we met in Beirut recently.
Yes.
How's the investment environment for startups going on in the Middle East right now?
The Middle East actually is witnessing a revolution in terms of prevalence of capital, increased number of transactions, and high quality entrepreneurs moving to cities like Dubai and starting businesses out of there. So it's the right time to be in the VC space. We're building up the market, we're building up exits. We are present at the entire value chain of supporting companies, bringing capital, both equity and sometimes debt, and working on exits. Very exciting times.
Where's the best place to do startups from in the Middle East right now?
When we talk about the Middle East, we focus on the Arab-speaking countries. And the cities where you have the highest quality entrepreneurs are Dubai, Beirut, Amman, Cairo. So those are pretty much the epicenters of talent. Yeah. Now the money could come in from several countries as well. A lot of club deals going on, a lot of government funding being poured into the industry, and more and more independent venture capital firms such as Middle East Venture Partners growing.
There's obviously a lot of stuff in the news at the moment about the political situation in various countries in the Middle East. I mean, how do you deal with that sort of, you know, that impression of chaos?
Correct. Very good point. We have to separate the political coverage in the media from the real economy. The Arab world today is home to 140 million internet users, growing at roughly 20% year on year, 70 million smartphones. The entire e-commerce business is a $15 billion business with amazing growth rates. So that is coming from a young population, an increase in wealth. The Arabian economy is a $1.5 trillion economy and growing. Obviously, what we see on the news is bad news due to political tensions and reshaping of some of those societies. Don't forget, 80% of the Arab population is less than 29 yeah. years old.
So it's very early days, and of course, it's still a growing economy on the ground in the real world, in the real economy. Thanks very much. Lovely to see you. So we're going to just take a little while, wander through a couple of the other companies here. TechCrunch Disrupt San Francisco this year is the biggest it's ever been, with over 4,000 participants. And we're just going to check out these guys over here. Oh, golf. I love golf. Now, Golfscape. Now, just tell us briefly about this, sir.
So Golfscape is... high-level concept. You're able to book flights and hotels anywhere in the world. For golf, this doesn't exist outside of US, UK, and a couple other countries. So we're in 47 countries. We're live today. You can book golf on our website. We've built it. It's kind of a marketplace, so the golf courses can come. They can create their profile, and the ones we reach a commercial agreement with, they're able to sell in real time. So what you're used to everywhere else, you know, you book, you get a confirmation instantly, you show up, they know who you are. This, I guess, it seems trivial, but it doesn't exist in golf, and now it does.
And is something you want to do internationally or mainly for the MENA region?
We're in 47 countries. So like I said, the big guys, they're in maybe 5 or 6 countries, tops. No one's in Asia, no one's in, you know, Spain, Portugal. We've got a course in Fiji, for example.
Oh, amazing.
Yeah.
Where are you guys running out of?
We're based? Out of the UK.
Out of the UK.
Out of the UK, yeah.
What are you doing in the Arab Pavilion?
Well, a business decision, actually. So a friend of mine referred us to here. I spend some of my time in Dubai. And we get to exhibit for 3 days and save some money on the ticket. So
there you go.
Entrepreneur, right?
Entrepreneur. Good to see you. Thanks very much, Golfscape. Over here we've got, what's this called now? Potential. What's that?
Potential.com is a blended learning business skills development platform.
Yeah.
So we open up the various programs for masses for free. Mainly focused on emerging markets.
Is it so like a MOOC or something?
It's the evolution of the MOOCs. We started doing the MOOCs about 5 years ago, before the term was actually coined. But we noticed that that's not enough. And as you know, MOOCs have a lot of dropout rates, low engagement. So our programs are a combination of online elements that include the MOOC part and also offline elements that include competitions, events, with a big focus on key cities across emerging markets.
Potential.com, how on earth did you get that domain name?
Well, we worked on it. So the company's been established for 10 years. And when we first went and started off the company, we wanted to make sure it's a global brand.
Yeah. It's a great name. Thanks very much.
Thanks.
Now over here, we have the luxurycloset.com, the Middle East luxury marketplace. What's that all about?
So it's a marketplace for luxury items based out of Dubai.
Uh-huh. And what's the closest comparison, say, to the Western market?
That would be the realreal.com.
And what sort of things you got? I've got some watches here with diamonds.
Yeah, so Dubai is the best place to be for luxury. It's synonymous with luxury, and you can see
better than Paris.
So the Middle East has the highest per capita spend on luxury, and it's twice as high as any place in the world. So, in Western Europe, I think it's about 600 euros a year, and in the Middle East, it's 1,400. So it's twice as much. So you can see we have this nice Rolex with diamonds, and it's only $62,000.
$62,000. It's a snip. Marvelous. And lastly, we've got, I think we've got a co-working space over here. Astrolabs?
Yes.
So what is Astrolabs briefly?
Astrolabs is a new startup hub that is based in Dubai in partnership with Google for Entrepreneurs and the DMCC.
You're partnering with Google?
Yes, Google for Entrepreneurs.
And is it, you're getting entrepreneurs together? It's a little bit like a Rocket Space in San Francisco or something?
Yeah, exactly. It's like 1871 in Chicago and all of these spaces. It's to have startups from the Valley being based in Dubai to access the emerging markets.
Yeah.
It's also local startups to be there and all of them interacting together.
Seeing a lot of activity?
Tons of activity now in Dubai. I think you've been a couple of times.
Yeah.
More and more activity, and we hope to actually help more entrepreneurs start in Dubai.
Fantastic. Thanks very much. Well, it's Mike Butcher from the startup, the Arab Pavilion here at TechCrunch Disrupt San Francisco. And it's just a taster, actually, of the fact that internationally startups are enormous, and especially in emerging markets like the Arab region. So we'll see you later.